up to the lab and see what's on the slab.
I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
Alright, thanks for joining us again. We got a very special edition of Scotty J's Trailer Trash for you this week. Something a little bit different than my normal fare. You know, if you've seen my show in the past, you know, I focus mainly on B-movies and B-movie schlock, you know, good movies, bad movies, forgotten movies. I'm going to turn the tables a little bit. As you can see, the set looks a little bit different. I'm not in the library this time around. God forbid, we're going to try to legitimize this show yet. We're going to start out this week's show. It's part one of a two-part deal that I'm doing, focusing on Hollywood epics and Oscar winners. Those of you that saw the Academy Awards this year back in March, things have changed a whole lot in the movie-making industry, but yet at the same time, the more they have changed, you know, basically, the more they haven't. We're going to start this week's show. We're going to go back to 1953 and with a young Marlon Brando and a young Lee Marvin, believe it or not. We're going to go back to the original trailer for The Wild One, basically the inception of the entire biker film genre. You go on to see such other bad B-movies, if I could interject this. Such as Daddy-O, Drag Strip Girl, anything like that, Motorcycle Gang, you know, the B-movies. But also along the same lines, other Oscar winners such as Easy Rider. On the heels of that, we're going to go into some early James Dean with the original theatrical trailer for East of Eden. And we're going to end this particular block with a film that was directed by George Stevens, the gentleman that brought you Giant, another James Dean vehicle. This one starred a young Alan Ladd, father of Cheryl Ladd, who went on to Charlie's Angels fame, made-for-TV movie Purple Hearts. Alan Ladd. So we're going to take a look at Shane to end this block, and we'll be right back.
Scrambling with the rebels. Remember?
What do you want me to do? Send you some flowers?
What's the matter, Kathy? I was only trying to...
Come on.
Get to work on these boys. Anybody bring a gun for me?
Yeah, here's one.
Phone's dead. You better send somebody for the militia.
Such startling characters.
Such untamed emotion.
Now it's the frankest motion picture ever made.
Hey,
They sneak in at night. And I walk in this front door in the daytime, see?
Don't you ever touch her again. You're no good.
And don't lie to me about
trying to help.
Every emotion leaps from the pages of John Steinbeck's best of all his bestsellers. And to bring new vitality to every explosive chapter, to capture for you the stark realism of people who love so deeply, hate so fiercely, live so recklessly, Warner Brothers had to seek out vibrant new personalities, tap new sources of talent, create new stars. James Dean as Cal, the wildest boy you've ever met.
Did it?
Did what?
Shot my father.
Because he tried to hold me. He tried to tie me down. Nobody holds me. I'm glad.
Your son, Aaron, he's everything that's good.
Say hello to your mother, eh?
Say hello to your mother!
No!
Studio that made Gone with the Wind brings you Duel in the Sun, a spectacular adventurous love story of the Old West with one of the greatest casts in motion picture history, headed by Jennifer Jones, Joseph Cotten, Gregory Peck. Duel in the Sun, the unparalleled thrill-packed spectacle that was 2 years in the making, photographed in magnificent Technicolor. Duel in the Sun, with Lionel Barrymore, Herbert Marshall, Lillian Gish, Waller Houston, Charles Bickford.
Loot, loot, honey. Don't do no harm to tell folks, will it, honey?
Defend Spanish Pit with lead. Now, if there's any yellow bellies among you, get out now.
The curve, the flesh of temptation. Resistance is going to be a darn sight harder for you than for females protected by the shape of sows.
I might as well say it. I loved you. Somehow you touched me.
You love me?
You dare to bring that Indian baggage right here into this house, and now you try to tell me. You get her out of here. And what's more, you get her out of here tonight.
Stevens, creator of such masterpieces as Giant and his Academy Award-winning A Place in the Sun, enlarges the scope of the screen, the motion picture whose monumental background is matched by the stature of its moving human drama. Drama that began when a mysterious stranger rode in from out of nowhere to play a decisive role in the lives of these rugged pioneers.
You call me Shane.
Shane, who attracted the woman with his quiet strength, who fascinated the boy with the glint of his gun.
We'd all be much better off if there wasn't a single gun left in this valley.
A gun is as good or bad as the man using it.
From the clash of elemental forces, George Stevens has created a motion picture unforgettable for its spectacle and scope, its great human story, its deadly conflict.
I've heard about you.
you heard, Sheen?
I've heard that you're a low-down Yankee liar.
And welcome back. Another note on East of Eden. It was actually also starring... actually directed by Eli Kazan, who also directed A Streetcar Named Desire with a young Brando. You're going to see shades of the same character in both of these movies, but very, very cool. The Wild One, directed by Stanley Kramer, also brought you Clockwork Orange, also brought you 2001 Space Odyssey, went on to become a legendary director in Hollywood. Right now, we're going to take a break, and we're going to come back with a movie that's been remade many times, but this one had kind of an odd pairing amongst its all-star cast. We're going to take a look at an early version of The Three Musketeers when we come back.
Snap! What a happy sound! Snap is the happiest sound I've found. You may clap, rap! Rice Krispies.
I say it's crackle, the crispy sound. You gotta have crackle or spark not found.
Snap, crackle, Rice Krispies.
I insist that pop's the sound. The best is missed unless pop's around. You can't stop hopping when the cereal's popping.
And welcome back to Scotty J's Trailer Trash, basically our Hollywood Classics edition. I kind of went out on a limb and kind of did some mainstream films this time around, some Oscar winners, if you will. This particular block, where, like I had said before the break, we're going to be seeing a film that's been remade many, many, many times. This one is a fairly early remake of a film called The Three Musketeers. And I had mentioned a fairly unusual pairing in the film. And basically, the film itself, it's funny. The billing in this film, it's a lineup of stars. Lana Turner, Gene Kelly, June Allison, Angela Lansbury, and yes, believe it or not, Vincent Price. The Vincent Price and Gene Kelly pairing is what I was referring to. This particular version was directed by Alexandre Dumas. So let's take a look at that. But we're going to follow these with probably two of the biggest epics of the time. We're going to follow Three Musketeers up with Lawrence of Arabia, starring Peter O'Toole. And we're going to, Oscar winner all the way around, 7 Academy Awards in total. Also starring Alec Guinness and Omar Sharif. Very outstanding film, very groundbreaking film for the time. Kind of controversial in some respects if you've seen the film, but we're gonna actually end this block with probably the best, I can't say the best, that's a strong word, in my eyes, the best and strongest gladiator film of all time, Spartacus, starring Kirk Douglas, Laurence Olivier, Peter Ustinov, and a young Tony Curtis. So just sit back, enjoy what movies used to be like, and we'll be right back to tell you what's coming up on next week's show. Stay tuned.
immortal story comes to life on the screen, and out of its thrilling pages step the most intriguing people you have ever met. The bold, the adventurous, the lovers, the schemers, the valiant and the villainous.
I deem him one of the greatest beings alive in our time. We shall never see his like again. His name will live in history. It will live in the annals of war. It will live in the legends of Arabia.
Who is he?
Bet.
Hamas!
What is your name?
My name is for my friends. None of my friends is a murderer.
Quarter of a century, controversy has raged around the name of T.E. Lawrence. No man of our time has drawn upon himself so much praise and so much criticism. Lawrence of Arabia, the man torn between two civilizations. Lawrence of Arabia, filmed against a canvas of awesome magnificence.
Lieutenant Lawrence is not your military advisor.
But I would like to hear his opinion.
Damn it, Lawrence, who do you take your orders from?
From Lord Faisal, in Faisal's tent.
Peter O'Toole as Lawrence of Arabia. What was he really like, this controversial figure who became a legend in his own lifetime?
He was the most extraordinary man I ever knew.
He was a very great man.
He was a poet, a scholar, and a mighty warrior. He was also the most shameless exhibitionist since Barnum and Bailey.
What, in your opinion, do these people hope to gain from this war?
They hope to gain their freedom.
There's one born every minute. They're going to get it, Mr. Bentley. I'm going to give it to them.
Lawrence and Arabia. Together, they made history. Now, a gathering of international stars unfolds the story. Alec Guinness as Prince Faisal.
The English have a great hunger for desolate places. I fear they hunger for Arabia.
Anthony Quinn as Auda Abu Taihi.
I carry 23 great wounds, all got in battle.
75 men have I killed with my own hands in battle. I scatter, I burn my enemies' tents. I take away their flocks and herds. The Turks pay me a golden treasure, yet I am poor. Because I am a river to my people.
Jack Hawkins as General Allenby.
I believe your name will be a household word. Well, you would have to go to the War Museum to find who Allenby was.
You're the most extraordinary man I ever met.
Leave me alone.
Huh?
Leave me alone.
Jose Ferrer as the Turkish Bey.
Your skin is very fair.
also starring Anthony Quayle, Claude Rains, Arthur Kennedy. With Omar Sharif as Ali and Peter O'Toole as Lawrence.
And our defeat will mean the fall of Rome.
Spartacus, a motion picture unequaled in the entire history of filmmaking, unlikely ever to be surpassed in the magnitude of production, in the fervor and passion of its conflict, in the tenderness and beauty of its love story. Nothing was spared to make Spartacus the superb achievement it is, neither time, nor money, nor talent. For in Spartacus, you will see the finest cast ever assembled relive history's most exciting and inspiring drama. Starring Kirk Douglas as Spartacus, slave, gladiator, invincible fighter. Laurence Olivier as Crassus, symbol of Rome's majesty and might.
I'm not after glory.
I'm after Spartacus.
Simmons as the slave Arinia, whose body was bought and sold, but whose love enveloped Spartacus with a radiance few men have known.
I love you.
Charles Lawton as Gracchus, the leader of the Roman Senate. Peter Ustinov as Bataiotus, shrewd and devious dealer in human flesh. John Gavin as Julius Caesar, ambitious staff officer. And Tony Curtis as Antoninus, who loved Spartacus like a brother. In the powerful story of the gladiator rebel who sprang from slavery to challenge the awesome might of Imperial Rome.
The symbol of the Senate, all the power of Rome.
I imagine a god for slaves. And I pray.
What do you pray for?
I pray for a son who'll be born free.
As grand a spectacle as Spartacus was, it was made on, in comparison to today's budgets, it was a shoestring budget that this film was made on. So many tens of thousands of extras cast for this film, basically built everything to scale, you know, from the Colosseum scenes to the chariot races, everything to scale, everything very historically accurate. You can't touch it, with the exception of Gladiator that was released this past year, year 2000. That's the only thing that's even come close to this. You know, very young Kirk Douglas went on to become major star. This was basically his launching pad to Hollywood, or his best well-known work in Hollywood. We're going to take a quick break, and I'm going to let you know what's coming up on part two of Hollywood Epics, Part 2, and Scotty J's Trailer Trash. We'll be right back.
Listen, have you noticed something very special about new Kellogg's Oop Free Oops Lay? They ills me so elicious day.
Yeah, and they smell good, too.
Smart kid.
crispy and delicious day for breakfast or for ecking snake.
They don't spell any different to me.
Why not?
I have a cold.
Oh, boy. Well, Kellogg's puts real orange, lemon, and cherry flavors with colors to match in these crispy little cereal circles made from oats, then spangles them with big, crunchy sugar crystals, and, do they else may delicious day. Try them. Sparkling with a gachet.
Elf may so delicious day. I have a terrible cold, you know. Luckily, it hasn't affected my appetite.
And welcome back. Before I forget, I want to thank my quote-unquote Bennett. No, I can't use that word. I want to thank the Good Times Home Video for being kind enough to donate these trailers for use in this show this week. Next week, we're going to continue on with our Hollywood Epics special. We're going to see the likes of Jezebel with Betty Davis. We're going to see the African Queen. We're going to see the original trailer for Casablanca. We're going to see the original trailer, actually a teaser trailer. I'm looking really forward to this. The original teaser trailer for Citizen Kane, starring Orson Welles. It had no clips from the movie. It was something that Mr. Welles put together before the trailer was actually released in theaters. So we'll take a look at that. We're going to see the trailer for Ben-Hur, The Ten Commandments, the original trailer for Gone with the Wind. I can go on and on and on, but I'm going to save some of these for next week. So until next week, this is Scotty J. On behalf of Scotty J's Trailer Trash, and, please, please, please support your local video stores, and support Hollywood any way you can. They're busting our, they're busting their butts to entertain us. The movies might not always be the greatest creations in the world, but they're entertainment, or they're meant to be entertainment nonetheless. So if you can't make a movie, obviously, support them any way you can. Go out and buy a ticket, go out and rent the movie. What else can I say? So until next time around, this is Scotty J on behalf of Scotty J's Trailer Trash. We'll see you soon.
Every day?
It's Professor Nutty.
Right you are. And it's time you tried a nutty breakfast for a change. Nutty tasting Maltex cereal. There's a real hot idea for you. Try delicious Maltex with a nut-like flavor that lasts to the bottom of the bowl and see how exciting breakfast can be. You know why Maltex cereal tastes so good? And why it's so good for you? Most cereals are made from only one grain, but not Maltex. Maltex is made from two grains, toasted wheat and malted barley. That's why the last spoonful tastes as good as the first. Take it from me. I just said a delicious mouthful.
Maltex tastes great to the bottom of the bowl.
Having Maltex for breakfast is really not such a nutty idea. Maltex, nutty, but nice.
Northwest Community Television, your local alternative.